हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ पीरियड्स। दिस इज पार्ट 6, ग्रेड 10th, पीरियडिक क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एलिमेंट्स। इन दिस टॉपिक वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट इन द पीरियड्स व्हाट अबाउट द मेटालिक कैरेक्टर। ओके, सो शैल वी स्टार्ट। व्हेन वी गो लेफ्ट टू राइट in the periodic table, left to right, remember left to right, this is left and this is right. When we go left to right in the periodic table, then metallic character decreases. We can say metallic character decreases and its vice versa is also that when metallic character is decreases, then we can say that the non-metallic character is increases. But how the metallic character decreases and non-metallic character increases? This is all about the metals and the non-metals, in which sodium, potassium and aluminium, these three elements are metal, silicon is metalloid, and the phosphorus, sulfur and chlorine are non-metals. Metals has the tendency to lose electron, non-metal has a tendency to accept electron. Okay, and what about the metalloid? It can make the covalent bonds, share the electrons. So when we talk about the sodium, its valency is 1. Here I am talking about the valency. So don't be confused. Here sodium has the valency of 1, magnesium has the valency of 2, and aluminium has the valency of 3. Valency, not valence electron. I am talking about the valency. So if sodium has one valency and it has one electron in outermost cell, it can easily loses its electron to retain there and obtain there the state of octet. It has 8 electron in the outermost cell. So in order to complete its octet, it can lose one electron. But when we talk about magnesium, it is hard to lose 2 electrons because it has a small in size. Magnesium has a small size respect to the sodium, and aluminium is a lot more small in size regarding to the magnesium. So sodium has bigger size, magnesium has little bit smaller in size, but aluminium is smallest in size if we talk about these elements. Okay, so here one electron is the tendency to lose one electron is little bit simpler, but tendency to lose 2 electron is little bit harder, and tendency to lose 3 electron is hardest. So in these three elements, the metallic character decreases. But when we talk about the silicon, phosphorus, sulfur and chlorine, then what about these elements? Here the valency of silicon is 4, it's metalloid, so it cannot lose or gain. It can share the electron. So we are not talking about this topic, this silicon. We are talking about the phosphorus, sulfur and chlorine. These are the non-metals. These three elements are non-metals. What is its valency? Then we know that the valency here 1 to 4 is increases and then decreases. Then what about the atomic number of phosphorus? The atomic number of phosphorus is 15. Then we can simply configure its element electron 2, 8 and 5. So what is the valency of phosphorus 3, so on. The sulfur has 2 valency and chlorine has 1 valency. So 1 valency means it can take 1 electron. So taking 1 electron is simpler, but taking 2 electron is little bit harder, and taking 3 electron is hardest. So here the chlorine is more reactive than these two nonmetals, and sulfur is more reactive nonmetal than phosphorus. So here when we go left to right in the periodic table, metallic character decreases but nonmetallic character increases. Okay, I hope this topic is clear to you. When we talk about the next characteristic, that is chemical reactivity. If you understand that what is about the metallic character, you can simply understand what is chemical reactivity when we go left to right in the periods. Okay, as per, you can say, you see that the valency first increases and then valency is decreases. So we can simply say that the reactivity first decreases because sodium can react with another nonmetals very easily because it has only one valence electron and it can simply lose the electron. It has a tendency because sodium is very reactive metal. But if we compare sodium and magnesium, then magnesium is a little bit less reactive than sodium. Magnesium is a little bit less reactive than sodium. And among these three elements, aluminium is least reactive. So first, the reactivity, the chemical reactivity decreases. And then it increases because here phosphorus has phosphorus has valency of 3. So tendency to accept 3 electron problematic, we can say that, but take 2 electron is a little bit easy and take 1 electron is more easier than these two. So we can say that the chemical reactivity first decreases because its valency increases. When as per the valency increases, the chemical reactivity decreases, and as per the valency decreases, then the chemical reactivity increases. Why? Because its valency first increases, so its chemical reactivity decreases, and the valency after this silicon, the valency decreases, so its chemical reactivity increases. How? I explained you. Thank you. And the next is nature of the oxides. Nature of the nature of oxides. When we talk about the nature of oxides, then we know that sodium is alkali metal. These are the metals, and metallic oxide are basic in nature. So these three elements, oxide has a property that it has basic in nature. So sodium oxide is more reactive than magnesium oxide, and magnesium oxide is more reactive than aluminium oxide. So here basic nature, or we can say that basic nature of oxides decreases. nature of oxide decreases. But if the basic nature of oxides decreases, then we know that chlorine is non-metal, and non-metallic oxide are, yes, acidic in nature. Then if the basic nature of oxide is decreases, then acidic nature is increases. What increases? The basic nature of oxide is increases. Why? Because these are the metals, these are the non-metals, and these are, we can say that, metalloids. Here, one more thing is very important, that two elements which has its oxide that is amphoteric in nature. What is the meaning of amphoteric in nature? Amphoteric oxides sometimes acts as acid and sometimes acts as base. So aluminium oxide and silicon oxide, these two metals oxide has amphoteric in nature. So all about this lecture, after this topic we will talk about the characteristic of groups. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.